everyone. Today I'm cooking something different. So let's start cooking. Today I'm cooking chicken biryani. It's very easy and simple. Watch till the end to know how it is made. And this is full of flavorsome and very, very yummy. For this, I have taken chicken, potatoes, onion, tomatoes and ginger garlic, pudina leaves, dhania leaves, finely chopped. To the chicken, I add the curd, grind the ginger garlic and make them into the paste and add to the chicken, mix well. Add in chili powder, dhania powder, turmeric powder and salt according to taste. Mix well. Add in the tomatoes, the pudina leaves, the dhania leaves. Again mix well and keep aside for 20 minutes. Now I have chopped my onions. In a big pan, I'm adding 1/2 cup oil. Once the oil is nicely heated, I add in the chopped onions. Fry till they are golden brown. This is just perfect. Now I take them out. In the same pan, fry the potatoes cut into half. Once the potatoes turn brown, take them out. The potatoes are ready. I've taken 1 kg basmati rice, which I'll wash it properly and soak it for 15 to 20 minutes. Another pan, add oil and akha masala. Fry it for 1 minute. Add water. Add salt. Give it a good mix. Cover it and let the water boil. The water has started boiling, so we will add in the rice. And give it a good mix. And let this cook. We will shift the rice pan to the other side so we can cook the chicken side by side, and both the things can be done together. Keep checking the rice. My rice needs just 80% to be cooked. I'm not fully cooking the rice because again I'll be giving dum to the chicken and rice, so only 80% we need the rice to be cooked. Now mix the chicken and let this cook for a minute or two, not more. Mix it properly. My rice is ready, 80% cooked, so I take out the excess water. Rice looks perfect. The chicken has started leaving water. Mix well. Add in the fried onions. Add all the onions and keep some for garnishing. We have not used any oil in the chicken, so here I'm adding 1/2 cup oil. Mix well. Add in kasuri methi. Mix well. smell lovely. Add in the fried potatoes. Mix well. Cover it and leave it for 1 minute. After a minute, let's check. Wow! Mix well. This is the time when you add in the rice. Add all the rice. And just settle it properly. Here I've taken some few strings of saffron. To this I'm adding 2 tablespoons of milk. This gives a biryani a nice yellow color. I'll add it to the rice. Add it completely, then sprinkle the leftover fried onions. Squeeze in half a lemon and half cup of pure ghee. We shift the pan to the other side, and here we are heating a heavy pan. Cover the biryani pan with foil very nicely. Now shift the pan onto the heavy tawa and put something heavy on the top. I have put the roti maker, and let this cook on low flame for 40 to 45 minutes. Let's make kachumbar. I have taken onions chopped, and to this I had 100 grams of curd and 1 glass of water, 2 green chilies chopped, few coriander leaves, 1 tablespoon of black salt, 1/2 tablespoon of pepper powder. Mix well. With biryani, one should always make kachumbar, because biryani and kachumbar goes very well. It's been 40 to 45 minutes. Let's check. Slowly open the foil. It will be hot. Wow. Now sprinkle some coriander leaves. The smell is awesome. Cover this and just let this again cook for more 5 minutes. It's 5 minutes now. My biryani. Every time remember to serve from one side, not from the middle. So the white rice and the yellow, everything comes out evenly. Just look. It has the perfect texture. It looks lovely. My chicken biryani with kachumbar is ready. Please try out yourself to know how tasty it is. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed my video. So please kindly subscribe, like, and share my video. Thank you. Enjoy.